Hello. I don't know why I'm so red. No idea. This is just a live coding session. You probably can't even see this code. I'm writing some Python, and I've had this website running for a while. The items in the blue, it was basically a very simple ticketing system. It was actually called Super Simple Tickets, SST. It didn't need a logon. It didn't require any authentication. It was used internally between myself, members of teams, and basically it was part of the Scrum process. You can look that up yourselves. And the basic cycle of a Scrum is a sprint, really. You have a meeting in the morning, discuss what you're going to do, work on those things. That's the Scrum piece. The sprint piece is where you actually have the things to work on, you know, defined by the product manager or the Scrum Masters, helping marshal things along. And in there you have stories. So if I'm a user of a web browser, I need to be able to see web pages. That would be an extremely simple story, but it's a hell of a lot of work. These tickets helped me control those jobs. That's what they did. That's what this was for. And it's run on a Linux system for, I'm going to say, 8 months without issue, without problems. Yeah, IT guy wants to get rid of all the, let me paraphrase this. All the systems in IT are Windows. I'm the oddball in having Linux and Unix style systems. So I've got to do some tweaking, some poking. And the first thing I thought to do is put a proper header on it so we can actually see this gray area with the header, this lovely CSS controlled looking, you know, thing. So I've got a login page. If we go back, so that was being served up. That was the login HTML being served up by the Python code. So this is the actual code. So that hello came from this piece of JavaScript here, button on click. Well, it's actually a div with the class btn button, on click, alert, hello. And then it's view ticket form submit. And you can see the Sublime has highlighted this thing, which calls list.html. But it doesn't. As you saw, it said hello, but nothing happened. If I click login, it goes to login. So I'm a bit lost as to quite what's the matter here. So name, ticket name, action is that, method is get. It should just get the list HTML. It should just get it. I'm going to just restart the script if I can. So this is an annoyance of Windows. Well, there's the same Python script that I never have an issue with stopping on Linux, and I can't stop it for some reason on Windows. So there is some information. It started the service. It's actually done a test of my ticket controller. I think it's done it. It's done. This is some test ticket stuff. So ticket controller is not. Let's just look at ticket. Let's see why it's testing my code for me. Here's the ticket class. I have no idea why it did that. So creating test ticket hello. See, it shouldn't be doing that. Creating ticket hello world. It's done it fairly early on as well in my program. Something's not right here. Something's not jiving. There's nothing to do here with tickets. There is no ticket stuff in here. There's nothing in the session manager. So this is what I'm adding, a session manager. From letting people log in, they have a username and password, or a hash, really. I store the hash. They get given a session, which is just a GUID. I can show you that doing it. So if I log on as me, that's my password, there is the session. You can see that. That's the stuff I've added tonight. That's all fine. I've not put a CSS stuff on it, whatever, but you know, and it goes to the next page. The piece that's stopped working is the stuff that's been working for months. Yeah, and I know that is the right code because if I change this to it's the end of the world. Save the file, and we deploy it from here to the templates folder. I know that's a bit pointless, but at the moment there's actually a piece of XML that tells me where templates is, and it's blank at the moment. So, whatever. Again, look, this, I can't break into this. There we go, finally broke it. Go back to 8000. It's the end of the world. And it goes nowhere. It doesn't even try and open list.html up here. So I click login, I go to login, no problem. What is wrong with this code? There doesn't seem to be anything wrong with it. So this is the world of... I love Python, and I've written a book to help people be introduced to Python, because I found the book I read was terrible. And then it's other things that stop this stuff working. I don't know why this HTML is not happening. Let's actually just view source. So view tickets form goes to list HTML, method is get. It's almost exactly the same as the line above without issue. View tickets form, copy, find, paste. There are two of them. They're both highlighted, look. You can't actually see that, but there you go. That's highlighted. That's highlighted. They're the only copies. These things are sent to try. See, the login is a diff as well. It's a div. Excuse me. This is a view ticket form. It does the alert, and then it will not submit. It's a lowercase submit. It's a lowercase submit. It's the last thing there. It's the last thing there. I really do not know why it goes nowhere. It doesn't even show up here, look. Click that, boom, immediately. 23, 24, 42. It's the end of the world, nothing. It's the end of the world, nothing. It's the end of the world, nothing. Let's swap their locations. So view tickets form is now above the index form. Just to purely see. And we get the file. Login stops working. And view now works. So why is this horrible thing at the end here stopping it working? If that was that, then that's been there just for this evening, but that's elsewhere in the system and has been fine on other pages. Login page now works. List now works. I'm not happy with that, because as you can see, submit ticket was one of those as well. So let me put login form to be the first thing we can do. These are the three actions on this page. Let's make just that call the function. I actually have my Python set so that if I haven't got HTML, it doesn't look up a file. If it has got HTML, it can take the template and put things in place for me. If I just pass list, it will just do the list function, which doesn't format things quite right, but it just puts all the HTML and CSS together to make me a list of the tickets. So let's go back one again. Let's go templates and let's save that. And then let's restart the program. So again, I can't restart the program. This is very annoying. So there we go. That's the program. That's the end of the world as we know it. G settings is missing. Line 309, page handler. Okay, page handler is there. And line 309 is right there. And I don't think it is. I've changed this earlier. So when I do G underscore, that would mean a global. When I do C underscore, that means it's a constant. P underscore is a parameter. M underscore is a member. L underscore is a local. This is a G. It's not anymore. It's a self M settings. And there is no function to get staging path. It's now just called staging dir. This is a change the directly access stuff. So staging dir, do that. Let's just find any more. I don't need a global there. There is no global settings. So find g settings. Do you not find any? Find. Okay, hasn't found anything. We can save that and we can restart the program. Let's go back. View tickets. Dinner as well know it. List dir not found. 257 in page handler. Page handler 257. This is another bug. I've actually split all of these out into separate headers tonight. It's OS list dir. So it's os.listdir. Import OS. I've not bought Sublime on Windows yet. I bought it on the other machines, but not on this one. Let's go on again. And let's go back to the front page. It's in the world list. The system cannot find the specified path staging. Do you know what? You're dead right. You can't, because there aren't any tickets on this machine. So let's create staging. There's the staging file directory. Add it to my repository. Let's go on again. There are no tickets submitted for review. So this is just blank. As you see, there's blank. There's no formatting on this or anything. So let's just submit a new ticket. Test. Submit. That crashed. That needs a G setting. So ticket controller Python needs the settings sorting out. So ticket controller, settings import there. And this will have a copy of the settings. Settings equals none. Def check settings. Self if self.m settings equals none. Self.m settings equals settings. And this will use self.m settings, and we'll just check. I don't want the XML. So the increment function is taking this and it gets the master ticket ID and increments it by one, and this gets the master ticket ID, resaves everything and returns the temp. So this is because I've converted stuff to be locals. So you see there's constants here. These are constants. I know they're not to be touched. It's a simple naming convention to help me control things in Python. Some people do this by saying that members are just called with an underscore at the front of them. I don't like that. It does tell a user not to access them directly, but so does m underscore. These are meant to be accessed, so they haven't got anything like that on them. This is all code I've done before. This is using my XML class to write them back out for me. This is using my XML loader to check, validate each field. So I'm happy with that now. Let's go back to the ticket controller. Check that we're getting a new ticket ID. We are. Let me create a new ticket. Let's quit that and start it over. Let's go back and submit again. None type for line 40. We haven't called check settings. self.checkSettings. That should be fine. I could look where the ticket controller is created from itself and make sure that it passes one in. Let's just have a look at that. This must be the page handler. There's the ticket controller. Check a ticket controller. I could pass it the settings here. So I could pass this self.mSettings so that I know the ticket controller and the page handler both share the settings. Go def init self.settings. Notice the P there. self.mSettings. Settings. And I want this to default to something, so I'm going to give it the default parameter of the settings. Should we start that? And go back and go call. Ticket controller has no attribute. Check settings. That's right, I took it away a second ago. Whoops. Kill. Let's start again. And submit. Variable result. Reference before assignment. Ticket controller 48. So that's result there. Result equals create ticket. So L result none. I'm going to make most of my functions are going to return a none if they don't start with a none. That's fine. That's just a bug. That's clearly been there on Linux for a while. It's never complained. There we go. Could not create new ticket. Error creating new ticket. Type object comment has no attribute, see root string. Is this because I haven't converted comment to XML yet? Which is something I need to look at. So error creating new ticket. Error creating new ticket there. STR, so base exception was handled. So create ticket from HTML post. What's that about? So let's find in files. Let's find C root string. Now I know that C root string is what I would use for an untyped object that needs to be XML'd in my XML class with the constants at the top. In fact, I can show you in the settings here. We have a C file extension there. In settings.py, we have C settings root string. So C settings root string. Okay. So C root string to me tells me that I've got something that's wanting to be root string but isn't. So fine. There. Ticket Python line 53. That would be just there. Extract comments. Comment.cRootString. Now let's just go to comment. Comment is a class I haven't updated yet, so we'll update comments. Here's the comment. So comment root string are all here, and these need to be XML properly. So let's move these inside the class. This is stuff that I've not updated in like a year. So this is what's to be XML now. Create date, time, body. Okay. Let's see. Comments. A comment is just a comment. So the body is the body. So we'll go for body equals nothing. And we'll go for create date equals nothing. And create time equals nothing. And we'll do. It's the dog. I wonder what the hell that was. Bill. Hello. What are you doing? Always have a mask on. So self.body equals parameter body, p body, creating ticket. So and we'll do self-created time. So these are the existing ticket items. So the assignment, that's the start of the function. If the date and time string are none, we create them, we get them now from the helper functions. Print them out, I don't need to print them out. Remove the white space before strings. There, that's a good point. That's a good point. So take the M's off those and we strip them. So take the M's off those. We now don't need these accesses because we've got direct access to them. These are not globals. They are self. And these don't have M's anymore. We generally now call this to XML and return our root. And to XML string, return self dot to XML dot to XML. That's a bit of a misnomer. I'm going to change that later, but the XML construct class, this class here that I'm returning from to XML, that's a construct, that's my construct. But it turns these into a string with a function called to XML. It should be called to string, but I've got a lot of code to change before I can change that. So this is a load comment from XML, and it loads those, and that is comment dot comment root string. I don't care about those. really, that's not the way we do it. Well, that is a way of loading. So this is not loading generically. This just says we need three children elements to our XML. So we have the actual comment, then we have the body, create time, create date. If we don't have three, then it's not a valid comment. So that's fair enough. But I will make a note of those so I can just print out any errors while I'm going. Invalid XML element count. Let's print invalid. That's an invalid comment XML element count. Invalid comment element XML group name. Type of terrible. And the last one is else print could not create XML comment from text. Okay, so that was the comment test. That's the stuff that we're seeing printed out, which shouldn't really be being run. I think this is a hangover that I've got. So comments are now XML, valid XML. So let's just test them. So Python comment py. Comment object has no get save string. Print do XML string. Try that. Do XML string. You're joking now. Do XML string. That needs an extra bracket there before I forget. Comment XML is not defined. Lines says comment from XML. Oh, they load comment from XML. Change his name, didn't I? I've got to do this as well. Comment object, there's no get time yet. It doesn't. It's just created time, created date, and it's body. Those. There we go. So CLS. So we created hello world, we did the time and date as those, we loaded it back, blah blah blah. That's done, yeah. So that comment test now works. I often have little functions called whatever test at the bottom of files so I can test them in isolation. Didn't realize I was only partway through this job. I thought I'd finished this job, and I'm beginning to wonder if I hadn't finished, or if I'm working on the wrong repository. This is a subversion repository. So it may not have been synchronized. But since I'm just doing this to spend your time, we don't care about that. We don't care about last error. So a ticket has inside it a ticket ID equals 0, which is an invalid ticket ID. Ticket title, which is blank. A ticket body, which is blank. And it has a list of comments, which is empty. Okay. We could just make these be set up. And I don't care about those. So there is also here a created date, which is blank, and a created time, which is blank. So those created dates and times can't be blank, I mean none, for a ticket. It has to be created at some point. Otherwise, the date time now is used for from the helpers. It's not loaded. Yeah, okay, so it's not loaded. Okay, comments are blank. Initial body is blank. I don't care about initial body. Extract initial body P loaded. What does extract initial body do, John? I can't remember. This is just junk. It's not going to be needed for this, for the changeover I'm doing to XML. Ticket title. So we remove the white space. We have to do that from those fields like we did in a ticket. So that is the constructor done. Extract comments and extract initial body are junk. Set last error and get last error needed. We don't need these get, but we do need to get a file name. And this is going to be the word ticket underscore plus the ID. So this is going to be str self.ticketID. Oh, that was the dog again. There are two. There's one there, and there's one there. They are dreaming. Okay, so get file name, and then get staging file name. Now, we don't need a global settings, do we? No. So what we do here is we're going to load settings straight from the disk. That's probably a really bad idea, but I don't want instances of settings everywhere right now. They were a global, they're not a global right now. And it's just called staging dir now. And this is called self get file name, and it gets the file name. And this is the same. It's called actual dir. If you're wondering as well, this isn't my normal keyboard. This is the Golem keyboard that I have reviewed, and I'm wearing it out. But as you heard, it's silent compared to the other keyboards I've got. I have them both in front of me. It's rather an odd situation. So get comment count, don't need to worry about that. I'll leave the get comment, I like that. I like add comment. So that's fine. Saving is now completely and utterly different. So that's saving ticket to whatever path. And we need to get this as XML. So get to XML. And we need a bunch of constants. So C. Ticket root string equals ticket. C ticket ID string equals ticket ID. C. My malware scan is complete. Ticket title string equals ticket title. C ticket body string equals ticket body. See ticket created date string equals created date. See ticket created time string equals created time. And see ticket comments equals comments. Now there may or may not be comments, but each comment will have many comment within them. That's how XML works, unfortunately. So back to 2XML. Self. And we have no XML input here. Let's grab both of those, stick them at the top, take those sim masters away. So L root equals XML construct sim ticket root string. That didn't type right. Root string. L root dot add child XML construct C ticket ID string str self ticket ID. That's as simple as I can get adding my XML together for myself. Child construct C ticket title string self dot ticket title add child XML construct C ticket created date self dot created date add child XML construct C ticket created time self created time root construct ticket body self dot body root. Right, so if len self dot comments greater than zero, so we've got a comment, and then we go comments equals XML construct C ticket comments, and then we need to add for each one. So for I in range len self comments L comment equals self dot get comment I. Simple as that. If comment, I don't want to do that. If it's in the array, it's going to be a comment, isn't it? So now comment dot add child, and that's going to be L comment up to XML. Be sure that will give us the XML, which it does. That's fine. And then L root dot add child L comments return root. I hope you can see how that follows the XML standard specification, in that we've put our elements, that are sort of multiple comments, in a bracket that is contained within the base comment. So saving this is even simpler now. Now file dot write to self dot to XML dot to XML. Right, so ticket's now simpler. Load ticket from file. It doesn't do any of that. So we L text equals L file.read, L root equals 2XML construct, text, and I've got some special code that does this for me. Check the type. Just there it is. So we turn a root, the content into XML. So there is the main root bit. So instead of content, it's text. And take it apart. And this is ticket.c, ticket root string. So now we know we've got the class type. This is a special underscore underscore class is a type of XML construct. We hope. And then we've got L, all these actually, temp ID is the default values. So 0 and blank. In fact, no, by default there should be none, because above in the constructor we had the special case that if we loaded and there were none, it threw an exception. And we don't care about the line count. And we will close the file there. And we'll create the ticket somewhere else in a minute. So now we want account, and then we want to go for x in range. Children I'm sure that's what we have to do. Oh well, this is actually a get count. We can do a get count, so count range of children. L root dot get count L child equals root get child x, so we get each one if l child dot get name equals ticket dot c ticket id string. Then we found the id, temp id equals int l child dot get value. And count equals one. Otherwise, child name equals ticket.c title string, temp title equals child get value. Count equals one. Otherwise, child.get name. Ticket.c created date string and L temp created date equals child. There's just some noisy people outside. Plus one, I'm putting capitals in there with a mono. There's no capital on the end. I think the shift key is going ticket.c ticket time temp created time equals child get value. Get name ticket.c underscore ticket body string temp body. Add a capital G there. L count equals count plus one. That's all we need to create tickets. But I also need temp comments. Okay. L if L child get name equals ticket.c ticket comments. This is a special one. We want to go drill into this one. We don't want to increase counts. We don't care if there are comments or not. But what we want to do is for y in range l child.getCount l inner child, which is a common, equals l child.get child y. So we get the comment, and do we want to get comment from XML? Yes. So that loads a comment from disk. That isn't what we actually want to do. We know we've got P. It comes in as a root. So this test is actually invalid. So can we add it in a different order as well? I've not followed my rules here. So date is 0, time is 1, body is 2. Well, I do do it right then. My brain farted then, I missed that one. So that's a P. P root, P root, P root. Return the value. This test is now completely in. Valid. L temp comment equals load comment from. So I need, yeah, that loads everything. So load comment from XML. I suppose load is the wrong verb. It should be create or construct from XML. Inner child. Okay, if l temp comment, I actually do this as well, if not, so I can spot it easier. Yes, you can use the not equal operator, but I can't spot them as easy if not. Equals none. That's just a quirk of my Python programming, by the way, and it's something I do in my book. I don't use not equals a lot, I use if not something equal. It's just more of a, but it does exactly the same thing under the hood, so who cares? L temp comment start append L temp comment. Okay, so if count equals, how do we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 things, and then we can create our result from temp ID, temp title, temp body, and true for loading, and create a date, create a time, and then we can go l result.comments equals l temp comments and just overwrite whatever's there. That's pretty cool. And we can actually move the close up there to directly after the read to make it a bit more neat. Okay. Else print unable to create ticket from XML. Yeah. You notice as well, this is something I don't actually make mention in my book. I should. I might update it. The lines for the ifs match up with the action you're taking. Print XML root is not a ticket, else print text could not be loaded as XML for a ticket. print node XML. Else print node ticket file found for plus p file. That's not a valid indent there. I'll take that all back one. Load ticket from file, save, blah 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 blah. Load ticket by ID. That's fine. That's fine. File name equals ticket underscore. Ticket underscore plus GID because I've changed that. And I need to load settings here. Settings equals settings. And this is L setting. And it's actual DIR. And that's staging. This is L settings. Right, let's def test ticket. So T equals ticket. And I don't really care. Ticket one. Test is its name, and its body is body, and it was not loaded. And it's created with none and none. So I could just do that because it wasn't loaded, and I can do t.save. And I can just see what happens. So Python ticket Python. Nothing bad seemed to happen, but I don't see ticket. And don't see it anywhere. I didn't call it, did I? Test ticket. First rule of testing. Test, you ran the test. it has no object make it body, so P 47. That's just a typo. That's T. Do it again. Ticket underscore ticket ID 58. I see ticket root string is not defined. You're right, they're all self, and I've got that wrong. Self dot and these are all ticket. See ticket root string is not defined, like C5. That's a self that I've missed. I'm an idiot. Ticket has no object body. It's because it's called ticket body. Where did I have body? Line 80. Ticket body. Ticket body. Saving ticket T1. Ticket 1 has appeared. Open with text pad. Ticket one, test, created just now, ticket body, ticket. Okay, that seems to work. So let's now do D equals ticket by ID one. Actual is false, so we'll go to staging, and we can do print D dot ticket ID, print print d.title. Is it t.title? Yes. Ticket title, print d.ticket body, print d.ticket created time. That's just created time. In fact, they should all just be that. This should just be title and body. It's just being too verbose. So never be afraid of going back and changing your code, folks, because you've got to live with it. And if you can't live with it, the next person that's got to live with it might hate you. So that's now just title. That's just body. That's created time. Created date. And test. T, and we'll run that to completion. Yep, we've got a fail. Ticket title 46. Ticket title 46. Going again. Load from disk 135. That's a capital N. Count is not defined. If count, it's L count. It's a local. See, that was a local helping me out there. Created date is not defined. Self.created date 38. Created date is right there. That was just silly. Yeah, created date, created date. That should be P. That worked. Attempting to load from disk, attempting to load from disk, saving to disk. Naught. Ah, didn't load the ticket ID. Ticket ID is ticket ID. Why didn't it load the ticket ID? Are we on my way? Temp ID. Temp ID. So zero comes from the construction. That's clearly from the construction. I put in a one, and it saved the one, didn't it? Yeah, it saved the one. This is the joy of programming. This is why I love programming. I love it and hate it. Let's leave it there. Yeah, so there's what's happened, but because this is not a strongly typed language, temp ID with a capital I, lowercase I, was being assigned to uppercase I, was not being put into the ticket. So it wasn't saying that temp ID was not being used. There we go, that's better. 111. That actually probably, the way I work with XML with these constructs for backwards compatibility with really ancient machines, this is a class I wrote myself. It can use any XML parser to turn the XML constructs the way I want them out. But in Java, C#, C++, C, you have to define these as variables to use them. This and certain other languages obviously just create, if you've got a spelling mistake, they just create a function, you know, thing to use. And the fact that I've given this a default value is probably a weakness. In fact, let's try it without these, because it should be fine as well. No, temp comments is not defined. That's probably just that one. The rest are probably fine. Yeah, the rest are fine. In fact, that's stronger code. So there we go. Just thought about that better myself. Yeah, that's better code. In fact, let's do that everywhere. Let's take out. Well, they are temps there. That's fine. Let's go to user. We don't want initials in user. Let's go to session. And we don't want load in session. And we do want items. Where else are there XML settings? We don't want these defaults. Settings. It's actually maybe a lot. I'm happy now. Now let's go back to ticket. Let's have a ticket. So D that we've loaded. Let's add a comment. So CT equals comment. And comment is just a body. It's just a body. Comment. This is a comment. Okay, d.comment. So add comment ct, and we'll do d.save. Okay, so we'll see what that does now. Could not append is still pointing to m underscore comments. And so get is, that's better, go. So did that save? Yes. That's, well, there's a bug. That isn't tabbed in. Nor is comments. Comments are not tabbed in. That's a bug in my XML. Again, that must have been there for a long time. Add tab at the beginning. We need to go plus something. Tabs, ptabs, there, that's very, very old bug. That's not so good. It's there, isn't it? So if I do it there, L result plus self add tabs p tabs. Let me run this. There you go. That's better. That's prettier. That was annoying. But I'll just check that one immediately because. To be a separate check-in of a file person name. So check-in fix long-standing bug in standalone elements with children not tabbing their close element to the correct location. Okay, so now we can check in ticket and comment as converted to XML, converted to using XML, and the console converted, and then we can go commit general fixes to XML loading, Python specifically sets any temp name in XML load, so have removed defaults to cause a unknown name exception to appear if we assign to a typo. Variable name. There's a lot more there than we think. Whatever. Now, let's go back to the actual program we were originally doing. There we go. Few tickets broke. So let's first of all create a ticket. Submit a ticket. Let's go and make sure we don't have any tickets. And this is a ticket. This is the ticket body. Oh yes, it is. Submit. Isn't working. So we wrote the ticket though. The ticket wrote out fine. That's good. Exception handling. Yeah, so it seems to be that something is still loading the ticket back up. And it's calling get ticket at it. Okay, this isn't it. I expected this. This is fine. So back to page handler. And we go to 92. So this is the replace stuff, the stuff I mentioned that's replacing back into the HTML. We're replacing new ticket, ticket ID, and it's DR. And that's get last errors fine. And that should be okay now. So just kill the program again. Yes, that's fine. Back, great. Submit a ticket, 10,009. That's fine. Let's kill those tickets. Yes. Let's go back to the menu, submit new ticket. This is a new ticket. Hello, void name. Submit. Turn to main menu, view tickets. Tickets fell on the face. Same bug. Page handler 286. So, shall we return ticket ID? The string and create a date and title and len of comments, rather than having access of functions, this all is. And this is unescaped body, because it is HTML escaped. The status is fine. The root is fine. So, let's see what that gets me now. Put load back up. And view tickets, end of the world. Blah. Blah, blah. 289 in this same one. HTML unescape. Attribute error. URL lib has no attribute. Unquote. In helpers, line 26. This is going to be something horrible. So, URL lib on Python 3 doesn't have unquote. Python 3 URL lib. So URL lib unquote Python 3. It's a search other people have done. URL lib parse unquote. So let's do try that except return URL lib. Pause. Temp. Dot un. Quote. Dot decode. Tf. Wait. Let's see if that works for what I want. And view. Module object is not callable. I get the attribute error, module object is not attribute. Parse instead, I must use URL lib unquote. Do you, Benjamin? Because I got that, but not because of the function. Module object is not callable. URL parse. Let's try just unquote. What? URL lib on the code Python 3. Someone's actually raised it as a bug in Python. Porting report, yeah. Simple reproducer works Python 3, crashes like in Python. Sorry, works in Python 2, crashes like that in Python 3. Changed. Changed in progress. Changed fix committed. On the 31st of the 1st, 2015. But it still doesn't. fix URL lib unquote imports. Decode headers before comparison. Urgency medium. So this is URL.parse.unquote. So URL.parse. Sorry, URL.parse.unquote. URL.parse.unquote. Okay. Their bug report says it. Okay. Yeah. Must convert string to lib. So that's in page handler. I'm sure it is page handler. And line 2. 2.1. And that's a string of a length. Rookie mistake. Everybody does them, folks. Everybody does them. If they say they don't, they're a liar. There are my tickets. That's taken me all this time just to get back where I wanted to be 2 hours ago. It's taken an hour and 15 minutes by that recording. Well, I've got something there. What's that? No idea what that is. Right. So, view ticket is still not working. Page 45, line 45 rather. Forty-five is going to be more of the replaces are wrong. So we'll do ticket ID. And the next one is title. And the next one is create date. And the next one is create a time, and the next one is just body, and this one is a string of the len of comments, and comment list for range. Then ticket comments, have I left get comment into ticket? I did leave get comment in ticket, that's fine. Okay, and these are comment and they are body created time in there. Okay, so this one is just body, and this one is just created time. And I don't want to print that out. That something's not happy somewhere. Ticket has comment, don't care about that. All that. These are debugging statements that I'm just taking back out for the moment. Okay. View. Drill end. I've done that wrong, haven't I? Fine, lent. Doop. Dooper. View. Ticket object has no get count on line 51. Page handler? Yeah. Go 51. Oh, I'm not using. Oh, next one, 51. Okay. So if len ticket comments script 0 from that. That's ticket. Don't want to do ticket. I want to do restful. Go back. View. Yay! There's the ticket, and there's it back. So these, but this is the original system then. So ignore the grey at the top and the boxes that are showing. So you could view a ticket, and they look like this. This was just debugging. They literally look like that, and you could just view them. And these were the stories that we were told, and we could add a comment to them. You could, what then was asked was that you could just delete the comment. So you add another comment or delete the whole ticket, or you can resolve the ticket. Now, what they want to do is have a ticket that you can comment on, and they all have a username, hence the thing you saw with the logon, and you can escalate a ticket up. But we don't promise that. So that's where I'm leaving this for now. I'm gonna work on this header. This is a constant gray header I want on all pages. The action is just a gap that I put in there. These are just divs and tabs. They've got styles. It's not a massively difficult thing. But as you change, if you log on, for example, the action to log on doesn't need to be there anymore. It can go away. There isn't a log out. Logins last for, I think I want them to last 30 minutes, but that will be a setting. I'm going to add that to settings. So the settings XML will change. I also want to just check that things get encoded properly. So that is that ticket with the void main in it. You can't actually see that. Right, you put it in the notepad. There's a notepad. Copy and paste. Font. Make it big. So you can see it encoded void main as this, you know, the tabs and the spaces and things were encoded for me so that they don't actually interfere with the XML. It's just what I've done with it. But yeah, that was super simple tickets. SST was the blue stuff, and now it's going to be super simple scrum, SSS. Not a lot to do about that, but yeah. So this is for, it's actually for a friend of mine's software house that I've been helping him with. They were a bit baffled by all these tickets and things. Super simple tickets has just been around for ages. It replaced track for them. We used track for a while, but they don't want to use Linux based machines and blah blah blah. So this is running on Python on Windows. Bye for now.